the inside. The green flag is in the air, and we're racing in Atlanta. Goes from wide to narrow through one. They've all made it through safely.
Cameron Smith with that hand out the window, flagging Matt Crafton. He was going to gun the gas, made that work.
Right side damage on that 25 truck.
We saw the front cars up in that third lane during their practice session. And believe me, that one Matt DiBenedetto saw too. He saw it up there. He said, I'm not going to waste any time. I'm going high. But his truck didn't stick.
Gamble that didn't pay off already. He's gathered it back up, but what kind of damage has been done with that 25 machine?
I don't really see any tire smoke yet. That's to be the main concern.
Oh, into the wall he goes.
Had to have a tire down, yeah. Michael.
Still green, but surely going to go caution here unless he can get that down out of the way.
Look how much damage even the left rear fender has been, Bill. That could be end of the day for the 25.
I was talking to Matt down in the garage here an hour ago, and he was talking about how much fun he's having here in the truck series and what a great truck he had here. Unfortunately, probably it's certainly not, may not end the day, but it's going to certainly cripple his chances.
He did a great job getting it off track without creating further damage to the other trucks involved.
Look at this push. That's DiBenedetto getting on the back of Freeze and really accelerating down the back, taking the lead, and then he decides to flare out, and this is where it goes wrong.
He's got a little bit loose. You saw the back end wiggle just a little bit, and he's so close to the outside wall, he had no room to catch it, Michael.
And he might have very well clipped the back of Stuart Freeze and jumps at the front of his truck. See if he gets, as he goes by, trying to go by Freeze. Right there, that little bit of a touch could have upset that truck.
So he'll have to dig out of the hole early. Matt DiBenedetto has come in, gotten fresh tires, and is back out. Top 10 in both races this season, but off to a tough start here.